I think the Klan's an extension of the Southern society and the Southern system. It's a white group that's the ultimate enforcer of a white society of separation.
Charles Morgan is a lawyer from Birmingham, Alabama, who had to leave his hometown because of threats to his wife and children after he spoke out against the Klan. Who does support the Klan's violence?
As far as support's concerned, I couldn't say that people support it mentally. They'd all say that they didn't. The nicer people would. But the Klan really puts into action what many of their words in the privacy of their homes and in their voting booths are. The Klan translates those into violent action. So I'd say no, the majority of people don't support it. They use it as a scapegoat for many of their own evils and many of their own faults. But it is a natural part of the society.
But doesn't something like the murder of Mrs. Luzo make people so revolted by what the Klan stands for that they change their own views about...
Oh, no, the capacity of man to rationalize is great. A tremendous capacity to rationalize. For instance, when the three kids disappeared in Philadelphia, Mississippi, remember what the people of Philadelphia said? They've gone to Cuba. Or it's just a fundraising stunt. And the children were bombed in church in Birmingham. There was talk that the Negroes did it to themselves. There are all sorts of rationalizations. She shouldn't have been there, many of the people will say. I don't approve of murder, but is the way that people will put it. I think that it's a shocking thing to people. Nobody comes out publicly in support of murder. But for the same token, I think that people find a way to rationalize their way around this. Witness Germany.
You don't think then the Klan is, by its acts, going to alienate people?
Well, I think it alienates a great number of people, and as I say, serves as a scapegoat. But I don't think by its acts it's going to destroy itself. I think it'll be destroyed by a totally different thing, and that's changes in the system of justice.
What changes would destroy it?
Well, I think that if we had an integrated system of justice in the South, rather than an all-white system, where all the judges are white, and all the juries are white, and all the prosecuting attorneys are white, and the defense attorneys, mostly all of them, are white.
But if the juries and the judges were honest men, you'd get convictions where there was a crime committed.
I think not. I think not. The juries and judges consider themselves honest men, but they they're representatives of their society. The presence of a Negro, if integration is valuable, the mere presence of a Negro changes thought patterns and changes the way people think and do. Witness the way people tell racist stories and jokes at tables in this country, dinner tables. But when the Negro waiter approaches, they talk more softly or they don't tell the story at all.
They never really are trying a case of murder.
Oh, no. They don't try the case of murder. It's really a trial of the society, and it's a trial of the image of the community, and they're a little bit worried about things, and they feel like they've got to mete out some punishment. Perhaps some of them do, but some of them just feel like they ought not give any punishment at all.
Does the Klan actually have a plan of campaign, a plan of organized violence?
I think not. I think maybe overall there's, of course, an approval of violence and that sort of thing, but I don't think that they have any plan because I don't think they're intelligent enough to be planners.
But how can they hope to achieve anything at all? Surely even the simplest man, if he's got an aim, will pursue it in some way, and having an organization and wearing hoods and having large meetings must mean there's some brain behind it, there's some intention.
Yeah, but they operate, not necessarily. That's too rational to apply to the Klan, and the Klan's not a rational organization. They go out in election times, and they put out nasty smear sheets against people. It's not that the Klan's large enough to control anything with their votes, but with their foul words and deeds and acts, they can influence people by frightening them, terrorizing them, and by spoiling the reputations of otherwise good men. But the Klan operates in a different way than this. They operate on the basis of a particular crisis or a particular thing occurring, and that's the way the Klan moves.
But are you saying then that the killings and the beatings and the bombings that have happened, which have been attributed to the Klan, are really not organized in any sense by the Klan, but are just a separate part of it, some sort of emotional?
No, I should think that the individuals involved, quite often, if not overwhelmingly often, are Klansmen themselves. And I think they do the acts because they're members of the Klan, and they do these acts for the same reason, because they're both, they're acts of hate, essentially. Joining the Klan is an act of hate. But I don't think that they're planned on high. Someone calls up and says, let's go down and bomb a church, or someone says, let's do this. I think they're planned in little groups, small groups of men. I don't think it's that organized in this sense or that well planned. I don't think they're intelligent enough to run a truly effective campaign of terrorism.
What sort of people join the Klan?
Oh, the frustrated, the people who are a product of the same system, the system of slavery, and are locked into the past. Emotionally, they're principally unstable people. They're illiterate, unintelligent. They're killers. They're the killers of the dream and killers of the night. They're men who have no other way to express themselves but by bullets and violence and hatred. They don't have all the layers of culture that other men have that lock into them some of the civilizing instincts and influences that other Southerners and people around the world do have. The Klan, the Klansmen, the Klansmen are the dregs of society. The Klan is the The Klan's the killer of the dream. That's who he is.